So this was the second club tournament of the year, and as usual, a cold front came through Friday, so we had tropic temperatures. Tried fishing a little bit on Friday to get a feel for what was going on, but it was just way too windy for me to be able to do very much. And from there, we go out on Saturday, and this is how it went. Sorry, the audio is a little messed up here. I tried to fix it as much as I could, but there's only so much you can do sometimes. Hope it's not too annoying.
I think that one's gonna measure up. That'll be 15, and he's gonna be 12. It's only 14. There's enough.
Yeah, can't make that much
stretch. It's a good fish, but it's only 14.
As I go to net this fish, watch my rods on the deck. There went one of my favorite combos right over the side. Luckily it got hung up in the net and I was able to grab it back. I don't really know why that broke. I probably should have retied, obviously, but the line, I checked the line after most fishes and it didn't seem to be too bad. Anyway, it happens.
That's another 14 incher. 13.5. That leaves the box. They're all pretty small, but they're here. that came good in the top of the mouth there.
Most, but not all of my fish came on a drop shot. I did get a couple on a shaky head. I think one of the ones I kept was a shaky head. I think being really slow and methodical was the way to go today. I watched a couple of my buddies come into the same area that I was in, and they did catch some fish, but in the end, we'll see how I ended up compared to the way they ended up.
Thank you.
was glad it finally warmed up enough to take off some of the layers. I don't usually have enough patience to sit in one area for a long period of time, but it was working today, so I did. This fish was literally tied up. The drop shot weight had gone through its gill plate and wrapped itself around the line on the worm, so it took me a little while to get it untangled and get it out of there.
It's a keeper. I don't know if it's going to help. We'll see.
You can see I wasn't too excited about that one. It kind of pulled off right at the end, but it really wasn't going to be any help to me. It might have been a keeper, but no significant help.
Thank you. feisty, but not big.
Watch the left side of the screen here, and I was lucky enough to capture this osprey on film. It didn't capture his dinner. This was the last one on the day, and it was big enough to call a fish. It happened about 15 minutes before I had to get ready to run back up for weigh-in. Less than 30 minutes left on the day. It was a good call for the final catch. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it real well here, but there was another osprey coming across with, he did have his dinner with him and was able to land in the nest there, you can see on the left hand side, and probably feed it to the chicks. So end result was I pulled in probably about 30 fish, about at least 10 of them were good keepers over the 15 inch limit that's required in the Potomac right now. And I was able to come in second with 12.77 pounds. I got beat by a little over 13 pounds. Really good day for me. Once again, sorry for the audio, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe.